Hey guys, and thanks for tuning in again. Today we'll be looking at the VAM-9020 digital meter. I bought this meter from Banggood for around $11, including shipping, which is not that bad of a deal considering all the functions and capabilities it has. The main reason I bought it is to hook it up to my DIY power supply kit that I made in an earlier video. Link is in the description as well. Here are the specifications. Its voltage range differs whether you are using an external power supply to power the display. If you are, then the voltage range goes from 0 to 90 volts. If you don't use a power supply, but instead rely on the power going through the device, then you are restricted to a minimum of 10 volts. It can handle a decent amount of current, 0 to 20 amps, which is nice for pretty much any electronics hobbyist like myself. Voltage and current accuracies could be better, but if you need more precise measurements, you are going to have to use a multimeter anyway. The refresh rate of the display is not too bad either, coming in at 5 times per second. The main unit is simple enough. The front panel has 3 buttons on it, up, out and down, and the various modes are displayed on the right side as well. The back of the display has 4 terminals. The first terminal is used for the negative output wire, the second for the positive input and positive output together, and the fourth is used for the negative input wire. If you want to use an external power supply to power the unit, you need to add the negative wire coming from the power supply to the first terminal and the positive to the third one. But before powering it up, there is one more step you need to do. We need to take apart the back plate of the display first by removing all the screws. Next, we remove the small solder bridge that is located above the terminals. Best way I found to do this is with a vacuum pump and a soldering iron. Just make sure to check with a multimeter set to continuity testing if you have indeed removed the solder bridge successfully. Now it's time to put everything back together. Don't forget to align all the plastic spacers correctly before putting back the plate with the screws in place. Here are all the wires I'm going to use. When you have everything set up, you can start connecting them one by one. If you connected everything together correctly, after powering on your 12 to 60 volt external power supply, you should see the display come to life. Here you can see that as I am adjusting the voltage on my power supply, the voltage on the display changes accordingly. For testing out the current, I used a small 5 volt USB dummy load, which at 5 volts can draw 1, 2 or 3 amps, depending on which switch I turn on. Last thing you have to do is to calibrate the display. There are 4 calibrations you need to do in order to get it set up correctly. 2 calibrations for voltage, one for below 20 volts and one for over 20 volts. To calibrate the voltage, press and hold the out button to go into calibration mode. You should see 0U for voltage calibration. Use the up and down arrows to correct the voltage. Next, press the out button 2 times until you see 2ES on the top. Press up once to select yes on the bottom display and out one more time to save the changes. Do the same for the higher voltage as well. Calibration of the current is basically the same. The breakoff point is 2 amps. I used 150 milliamps to calibrate the low end and 3 amps to calibrate the high end. Again, press and hold the out button to go into the calibration menu. Press out button again until you see 1C and calibrate your low amperage setting first using the up and down arrows. Once done, press the out button again until you see 2ES and press the up arrow to select yes on the bottom. Finally, press out again to save your settings. Do the same for the higher amps as well. And that's it. Now you have your VAM-9020 display connected and calibrated correctly. In one of my next videos, I will be installing this display in a case I am making for my DIY lab bench power supply. So please make sure you subscribe to see more interesting videos like this in the future. If you have any questions or if something wasn't clear, I'm always happy to answer anything in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.